Tinatayang aabot sa 180,000 out-of-school youth sa bansa ang makikinabang sa bagong proyekto ng US government sa Pilipinas sa pakikipagtulungan sa DepEd at Technical Education and Skills Development Authority o TESDA. Ayon kay US Ambassador to the Philippines Sung Kim, ang programang Opportunity 2.0 ay pangsuporta para sa pag-aaral, pagtatrabaho at kabuhayan ng mga Pilipino out-of-school youths. Anya, batid naman ng kanilang gobyerno na maraming bansa, hindi lang ang Pilipinas, na lubos na naapektuhan ng COVID-19 pandemic.
Opportunity 2.0 program is part of the US-Philippines Bilateral Agreement on Education, through which the US government has invested roughly 600 million pesos or $12 million a year to support improved outcomes in basic education. In the Philippines, more than half of the population is under 24 years old. Many of these people in the youth category are either out of school or unemployed. These facts present both challenges and opportunities to fully realize the potential of these talented young people. This issue is, of course, not unique to the Philippines, as many nations face adverse socioeconomic effects due to the COVID-19 pandemic. More than 1 billion children and youth globally have been affected by school closures. Experts predict that the number of youth who will drop out of school, who will become unemployed, and who will become unproductive due to the lack of opportunities will rise dramatically in the near term.
Ayon sa opisyal, ang ibibigay nilang 37.1 million pesos para sa 5-taong programa ay ibubuhos sa alternative learning system ng DepEd at skills training programs ng TESDA. Batid-anya nila ang mga talento at determinasyon ng mga kabataan Pilipino para umangat ang antas ng pamumuhay sa kabila ng kahirapan. Kaya't iniaalok nila ang programa sa pamamagitan ng United States Agency for International Development o USAID.
Through this new partnership, we can leverage a range of resources to maximize the potential of the Filipino youth, particularly those who are out of school or unemployed. With the right knowledge, attitudes, and skills, they will play a pivotal role in this great country's growth and success over the long term.
Inilatag naman ni Dr. David Hall, ang program chief of party, ang detalye ng Opportunity 2.0.
In more detail, we'll work with DepEd in a variety of ways by embedding experts in the ALS task force. We'll help to improve curriculum and delivery modalities. We've already adapted the life skills curriculum into handbooks for self-directed learning in response to the COVID crisis. And training is going on this week in fact. We'll support teacher professional development by adapting the EDC Skills to Work sourcebook and by setting up summer institutes. And we'll work to strengthen the monitoring and evaluation capacity of the task force. With TESDA, we'll be working to assist them in ensuring that workforce development systems are responsive to employers' needs. And along with the development and certification of 21st century skills curriculum, we'll be helping TESDA to conduct local labor market analyses to better understand the regional need in terms of workforce and market content. And we'll be helping to improve the capacity of local training service providers to reach more out-of-school youth.
Ibinahagi ni Alexa Grace Elonde ang pagbabago sa kanyang buhay mula sa isang dating out-of-school youth at ang nagawa sa kanya ng alternative learning system ng DepEd.
Before namin na-meet si Anz, kami ng kapatid ko is nabilang sinasabi nila na out-of-school youth or yung mga kabataan na hindi nakakapag-aral. So during that time, tumutulong kami sa mother namin na magtinda para ma-support kami financially. Before namin nakilala si Als, nawala na kami ng pag-asa na someday matutupad pa namin kung ano man yung mga pangarap namin. Kasi syempre, hindi kami nakakapag-aral. So, noong time na yun, nakilala namin si Als, naisip namin na may pag-asa pala, hindi pa pala huli yung lahat para matupad namin yung pangarap namin. So ngayon, I am teaching at Kalan Systems Technology. And isa rin ako sa mga guro na nag-encourage yun sa mga estudyante na nawala ng pag-asa. Kasi nga yung iba, like yung mga gumraduate sa ALS, is hindi sila nawala ng pag-asa. And someday, natupad pa rin nila yung pangarap nila.
Samantala, ibinahagi naman ni Education Secretary Leonor Briones na ngayon taon, 48% pa lang na nag-aral noong nakaraang taon sa pamamagitan ng alternative learning system ang nag-enroll ngayon taon, o 357,196 sa 739,872. Ito anya dahil na rin sa epekto sa ekonomiya ng kasalukuyang pandemya, kaya't anya napakahalaga ng bagong programa ng gobyerno ng Amerika para sa mga kabataang Filipino.
And this is why Opportunity 2.0 is very, very important. Parents who have lost jobs, workers who have lost their jobs and who used to attend IELTS sessions during their off hours are not able to do so anymore. The parents cannot send their children, and this explains why the downturn in enrollment is largely in the private sector. And so preparing our learners as an alternative to formal education, giving them skills, teaching them skills, teaching them to prepare for the world outside, for the world of work outside, will surely contribute to the resuscitation of our economy.
Sinabi naman ni TESDA Director General Isidro La Peña na sinimulan na nila ang pag-aalok ng mga new normal skills programs na layong makatulong sa ating mga kababayan na magkaroon ng kabuhayan sa gitna ng COVID-19 crisis.
The project's aim of providing out-of-school youths with opportunities to uplift their socio-economic standing through various education interventions is in sync with what we are doing in TESDA. Even before the pandemic, our programs and services have been calibrated to provide extra attention to the disadvantaged and marginalized sectors, including the out-of-school youth. Previous work we have done with USAID Education Development Center and other partners in the Mindanao Youth for Development or MIDEV program have contributed much in development of out-of-school youths in Mindanao. Through our agency's guiding principle, TESDA Abot Lahat, we remain true to our calling of providing relevant, accessible, and high-quality technical education and skills development opportunities to our clientele. As the country continues its fight against COVID-19, we are laying the foundations for living in the new normal, not only to guarantee the safety and well-being of each Filipino, but also to provide them with livelihood opportunities that will contribute towards our economic recovery.
Janice Cosio, Radyo Inquirer, Nuevo Benta, Bayan Nagtatanong, mamaya nag-uusisa.